Hello, my name is Marianne McGrain, and I will be your son or daughter's Earth and Space Science teacher this year. My name and my email address is listed up on the screen. So I'm just going to take some time to go ahead and share what we are going to be accomplishing this year. First of all, I'd like to say I'm super excited that we are all together in the classroom. Last year was tough. Really, for the last year and a half, it's been a hard row in school. So we are working really hard these first couple of weeks to do what I call a boot camp. We are transitioning and learning about things like independent variable, looking at graphs, practicing claim, evidence, and reasoning. That's kind of what we're working on so that we can get our feet wet. My job is to really try to help the kids get their thinking going, get the process started again, have that critical eye start to reason and think like a scientist, like a high school student. So that's what we're trying to do. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what it is. Let me move this out of the way. So our topics for learning in Earth and Space Science this year are going to be origins of the universe and then Earth's place in it. That's what I'm starting with the kids actually tomorrow. We're going to be building models first and talking about what models are, and then we're going to be kind of processing into the most well-recognized theory between how the universe started, and then we're going to move into stars, and then we're going to be talking about Earth and our place within the universe. We're also going to be talking about Earth's internal processes as we move through the year, natural cycles as far as carbon cycle, water cycle, rock cycle. We're going to be touching on weather a little bit, and then just doing that though as an intro into climate, and talking about how climate is just really weather patterns over long periods of time and looking at different climates on our globe. Then we're going to be talking about human impacts on Earth, and we're going to be looking at things like populations, resources, why people live in the land and the areas of the land that they do, the resources that are there for them. We're going to be then talking about resource management and then societal solutions for how we can better manage our resources. So how to be successful in my class. It's really a time to take ownership of the students' learning. Now we are in high school and we really want them to be transitioning into more of an independent learner. That's the big push for us this year in Liberty that administration has given us because we have had such a delay in learning because of COVID. We really want to focus on getting our students to be more independent in their learning. It's time to create a team with the teacher, which is me, and also their peers. We want to ask for help. We want to create study groups. We want to make sure that before we say, I don't know, we want to stop and think, how can I find out for myself? And then we also want to try to really complete all the homework and projects that we give in class. It's important because we talked today a lot about what does a successful student look like, sound like, what do they do, what don't they do. And a lot of that, the students were telling me that they need to keep on top of their work. And that if they keep on top of their work, then the grades that they want will come from that. It's also really important to be prepared for class. Bring your materials. That includes a laptop that is always charged. Please make sure that your student is charging their materials at home. We are in this electronic digital age now. And then makeup, any works in, work tests and quizzes. We have something called Liberty Time that we have on Tuesdays and Thursdays. That's time for students to come on in. Any labs that they make, they're responsible for making up any homework. It is not all right anymore to show up and say, well, I was gone on that day. You still are responsible for the work that you missed. So always keep in contact and check Canvas to see what it is that you missed on any day. And then engage in our class and engage in school activities, belong to this school, belong to the community, build a community so that you can feel and your student can feel more part of something larger than themselves. I think that really helps with success. I'm super excited. Contact me, email me, let me know how you and I can partner to help your student be more successful in my class. And have a great night.